Want me to shoot you? What do you want? Okay, I understand. All right, I'm coming. Hey, get out of here. This land's job. Come on now. Come on, pick yourself up.
Firing a gun, cause an avalanche.
Boy. Hey. I'm going to Grizzly City. You want a lift?
Thank you.
Hey.
I have some furs to sell.
Come on, let's go. One second. I'd like to know who that idiot was.
Hold!
Hiya, Sitting Bull. How come you're standing? I'm going in town to sell my merchandise. Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. I'll look after your dogs.
Thank you. Good luck.
$1 for team, $2 for Big Wolf.
The wolf comes with me. You take care of the team and the sledge.
Okay.
Ferguson. Hey, say, friend, who's this guy Ferguson, eh?
I mind my own business. Clean your feet before you come in.
Okay?
Hey. Artillery over there. Go. A bag.
Huh? A bag? What do you mean? Samples are no value, eh? Hey, give me a double one.
Glass?
No bottle.
Want me to wrap them up?
What do you mean, wrap them up? I'm gonna drink them right here now.
Hold it. Has this man paid?
Yes, Mr. Slider.
You can pass.
This one's on the house, mister.
Why, that's mighty nice here.
Clean your feet before coming in.
Yeah, sure. That okay, friend?
The gun, there.
Gentlemen, pay attention. Got it. Look at what I got! Hey! Original Italian ties made specially for hard-working gold miners. Hey, with one of these adorning your front, you'll make all the dandies from Boston and Philadelphia go green with envy. Ha, ha, ha!
Just look here.
So then, they're 23 pieces, which makes 23 ounces.
23 okay. Ounces? You must be crazy. Why, they're worth three times as much.
3 ounces of skin. Well, for that amount, I would even sell my own. Well, then.
I can't sell at that price. It doesn't even belong to me. My
well, what do you
thing,
want
I've
from
roofed
me?
Them. I try somewhere else. There has to be a better deal around town somewhere.
Do as you please.
Oh, so long.
Be seeing you.
Walk up, fellas. Come on. Who's going to be the first fire?
A miserable buck for 5 shiny ties. Well, now, come on now. Who's going to be the first to buy one of these beauties? Who is going to be the first to make his bell vibrate with love and passion? Who will wear this symbol of wealth and elegance around his neck? Adorn yourself with this beautiful silk. Come on now. Who's going to... Hey. Hey. No more religion around here anymore. Damn it.
Give me 2 bags of beans and 1 of flour.
Sorry, no sale.
What do you mean?
I mean that who doesn't sell doesn't buy.
Hey, you want a drink?
No, thank you.
Listen, friend, my partners stayed in the mountains. I must take food back to them.
Who doesn't sell doesn't buy.
Friend, I can't stand bullies. Do you hear me?
Oh, yeah? Forget your damn skin. I hope for your sake that you've understood what good manners are, friend. And you got anything to sell?
Me? I don't sell and I don't buy.
Make that beast of yours shut up.
I'm sorry, seems you're not his type. Come on, White Fang. Be good.
Be seeing you, friends.
Didn't you come into town to sell your skins, buddy?
That is a vulture's nest. Don't like to be taken for a ride. Good luck, Dollar.
Bye now there. Good luck, Daniel. Hey, now would you Would you wear one of these around your neck?
Not even at carnival time.
Why, you dare insult me?
Come on, selling ties here is like selling fur coats in the tropics.
Why, you good-for-nothing preacher, Dollar sells fur coats in the tropics and he sells fridges to the Eskimos.
No need to get heated up like that. I'll take one.
Hey, you. Ferguson, my neckties are yours.
Let's try to reason. Yes? You have a son. You're a widow. You can't possibly manage a farm on your own. You should know that. Now, you know how friendly I was with your husband.
Don't insist. I won't sell.
Think it over. John and I built this town together. And I won't allow his widow to live like a peasant. Remember, I asked you to marry me the day after John's death, and my offer is still valid.
To make amends for something you might have done.
How can you think that I had anything to do with your husband's death? That's perhaps why you obstinately keep a farm that isn't worth anything. Just because of some malicious gossiping, you want to keep your son from something he deserves.
Go sell business. I got a fantastic deal on some rolls on Mr. Ferguson.
I'm sorry, sir. Mr. Ferguson treats his business only at the bank.
Come on, be reasonable. Sell your farm. Like that, you'll be able to send Johnny to a good college, maybe even in Boston.
I will never, never sell, Ferguson. You will not become the owner of this region with my help, even if I should starve to death.
You know I don't like that, Mr. Ferguson. And what's more, he's ugly.
You mustn't call Mr. Ferguson ugly. Ugly men don't exist.
Well, yes, sometimes they exist.
Well, what do you want?
Can I ask you?
Little Johnny!
It's bad manners to talk to strangers. Come here.
I only wanted to ask him.
No, Johnny, you should not question old people. It isn't very nice, you know.
No, please, Mrs. Squaw. Children always ask some questions. And then I'm not old.
I didn't mean
Why,
to
me,
offend
I'm
you.
I'm only a traveler. Now, put your question, my little friend.
Tell me, do you work in a circus?
A circus? Hey, now what would I do in a circus?
The clown.
You little...
That's enough now. Let's go and wait for your mother.
Listen, you better make up your mind, because I have
Let's
my
go this way, Johnny. Goodbye.
Bye.
Don't be so stubborn. You have to sign for the good of the community and for the good of your son.
You mean not for your own good? The farm will never be sold. That was my husband's last wish.
Very well. I guess that's your choice. But is it also Johnny's choice? Are you sure that Johnny wants to live this kind of life? Huh? Answer me.
Johnny is outside. Why don't you ask him?
Johnny!
Mr. Ferguson! I offer you a fantastic deal. Hey, look, that deal of a lifetime.
Snyder!
Look at the ties. At that point, Snyder and a dozen men burst into the room. With one hand, I caught one. With the other hand, I grabbed the chair. And with the other hand...
For God's sake, how many hands have you got?
That's right. Yeah, there must be something wrong with my memory. Anyway, they beat me up, so I decided to come with you.
You did the right thing, Dollar.
Look what they did to mine.
Come on here and eat.
Yeah, I'm coming. Damn, Slider. Don't you ask me why I sell ties, huh?
I don't ask you anything.
Well, in that case, I'll tell you. I won them in a poker game, and when I tried to exchange them for a bottle of whiskey, they laughed at me. So I decided to sell them to someone, no matter what. And I will. You can bet your life on that. Yes, I will. I don't think in this kind of weather a rabbit would willingly do without his fur. What do you say, Daniel? Could it have been done by some wolf, huh? What do you say?
Tie the dogs up close to the fire, Dollar, and tie up White Fang, too.
Okay, Daniel, I'll tie up the dogs close to the fire and White Fang, too. idea.
Oh, yeah? What is it?
Hey, let's scram. Hey, you listening to me or not?
Yeah, sure, sure. Continue. Go on.
I said let's fly, scram, duck, get out. Hey, come on now.
Why didn't you say that if you go back to town, they'll have you hide?
Oh, but I prefer 1,000 Fergusons to 1 lone wolf. To hear them give me the shivers. Yeah.
Hey, what's happening? What do you want? Dollar, wake up.
What is it?
Dogs are gone. The wolves carried them away.
Huh? The wolves?
Yeah, they must have come close.
That's how you tell me. Damn poker game. I'd even mark the cards, and now I find myself here at the mercy of the wolf for a bunch of ties. God, my damn luck. Hey, listen to him.
I'm listening.
Hey, let's get the hell out of here. Come on.
Can't be done.
What do you mean it can't be done?
They're already on us.
Well, oh, good heavens. Come on, then. Come on, let's get ready. It's an automatic.
All right, Dollar?
What are you, trying to be funny? Why, that son of a wolf has bitten me.
Oh. Don't worry. I'll clean your wound. A little whiskey will fix you up in no time.
Whiskey, you say?
Yeah.
Oh, no!
Am I hurting you?
Oh, here. No, you're wasting all my whiskey. You know the owner of this farm?
No, but I won't refuse us hospitality.
Let's hope not. Ain't nobody here.
Anyone there?
Hey, anyone there? Maybe it's abandoned.
No, it can't be.
Why not?
Doesn't look abandoned.
Well, how does an abandoned farm look like, eh?
It looks more abandoned. Let's go take a look.
Yeah.
Come.
trigger happy, that one.
What do you two want?
We're honest merchants looking for work. Mrs. Squaw knows me.
Don't move.
But we've been attacked by the wolves. You can't send us away like that.
Tell me why not. I don't see why I should trust you. Go back to where you came from.
But there must be 2,000 or 3,000 wolves out there. Maybe more.
I know you. You're the clown of the circus. Don't you work in the circus anymore?
Johnny, come here.
Don't worry, Mommy. Nothing's going to happen to me. I've got Pennywick with me.
You mustn't be afraid, madam. We're hunters. My friend is wounded. And my dog is dying.
I'm sorry, but I can't do anything for you. Go away.
It's true what they're saying. The dog is wounded. Please, Mommy, please.
You can't refuse them help. It wouldn't be right, I don't think.
Madam, I appeal to your generosity and for help.
Oh, very well, but only for a single night.
Finally, you woke up. You slept like a log. You passed right out. As soon as we got here last night, you know, the women and the kid, why, they really got busy. They cleaned us up all together, dressed our wounds, everything. Yesterday, the men were out with the cattle. That's why the women were so scared, like.
Hunter.
So they say.
Is it true that your dog is a famous trained wolf?
So they say.
Is it true that you fought against the wolves?
So they say.
Gee whiz. My name is Johnny.
Mine is Daniel. Friends, right?
Johnny, come here.
Bye, Johnny.
Bye.
Go and drink your milk.
I don't know how to thank you.
You can stay here a few days more if you wish, but don't talk to my son.
Why not?
His father died less than a year ago.
Oh, I see.
And Johnny desperately needs attention. You have all the qualities to appeal to him. But soon you'll go away, and I don't want my son to suffer.
I understand.
These are 100 wolves with sharp fangs. Their nails cutting like razors. Oh, you should have been there, Johnny. You should have been there. 100 of them in front of me, and they all jumped up at once. All of them. Yeah, I shot and I killed 2 of them. And then the third one, he jumps up and knocks my gun out of my hand. And so I grabs him by the tail and I spins him around like this. Spin him around. And I kill them, all of them. Oh, I thought I'd kill them all. I made a terrible mistake. I forgot the one I was holding by the tail. I crossed my arms to take a breather, and that one whang. Hey, come and see, Johnny. You see this arm?
Yes, the bitten one.
That's right. Now you see it, and tomorrow it won't be there anymore. Be finished, destroyed, vanished, devoured by worms, consumed.
But why?
Because I'm allergic to the bite of wolves. Allergicus lupus et agnus morsicatum sunt.
You talk like a priest.
Yeah, yeah, noblesse oblige. Oh, lupus in fabula. You see, my son, these are the first symptoms. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord.
Do you want me to call Daniel?
No. You want to do something for me?
Mm-hmm.
Go out and steal some whiskey for me. It's the only way to save this poor soul. Go, my son.
Is it true that you're allergic to wolf?
Surely I am.
And that only whiskey can save you?
Absolutely so. Water.
You should be ashamed of yourself lying like that to little Johnny.
Why, it's a miracle. I've been cured. My heavenly saints.
Did you hear? He's cured.
Yeah, I'm cured, and you cured me, huh?
Stop.
Oh, let me embrace you.
Let him embrace you. He only wants to thank you.
Hey, listen to little Johnny here.
Okay, but no water that burns.
What is alcohol compared with the many joys of love?
Hey, Redders, cowboy!
Come on, Greg. Work him out, boy. 2 extra days pay if you stay on his back. Come on, don't hold the reins so damn tight. Work him out more with your knees.
Sweet Indian love, when you threw that bucket of water, I understood what you could do for me. Oh, wonderful.
What can I do
wonderful.
For you?
Save me from bankruptcy.
And how?
By washing my ties. Come here. Come and look. This is all my capital. Right here. And I'm in your hands.
If you really want to.
Oh, come here, my sweet Indian love. I want to embrace you. Oh, how I love you. Oh, I love you.
Who do you love more, me or the water that burns?
Oh. You raised in me the Hamlet question. Do I love you or that whiskey? To love or to drink, that is the question. Unless...
Oh, unless?
Unless we... I managed to do the two things jointly.
Listen here, boys. 3 days pay for who tames him. And Greg will pay for it. You gotta wear him down, Greg. That's the only way. Come on, you gotta stand his back. Don't pull his head off. Go easy on him.
Gently. Don't pull him.
And go to hell.
Why do you interfere?
Hey there. Don't be upset. We have a professor here.
By the way, aren't you a dog trainer?
I only gave advice.
Hey, Daniel. Reserve your advice for the dogs.
Hey, Daniel. Teach him a lesson. Show him who's stronger. Come on.
I'm an eagle. It's the earth that's slipping away. It's an earthquake.
My great love, take me with you.
Come here, my sweet squaw. My darling. You keep still. Well now, that's it. Where is the will? There's a way. I'm up. I go. I come back.
Whoa.
right there.
Come in here anymore.
That's what I should remember.
This will refresh your memory.
What are you trying to do to me? Hey, why don't you double up? It ain't fair. Which will be the right one? Only I could cancel one of you. Hey.
Johnny, have you seen Dollar?
Rising Moon said that Dollar went into town to buy the wedding rings.
In town? Thank you.
Daniel, if you come to town to look for your friend, I know where he is. Follow me.
Look for Dollar. Quick.
The locomotive, having left Lodge City, travels at speed towards Grizzly when unexpectedly an obstacle stops it. Do you know why? Because, you see, this land doesn't belong to the railway, but to Linda Burton. And do you know the meaning of that?
No, I don't know. Where is my friend?
You are staying at Linda Burton's. She'll tell you that her late husband and I were partners for a very long period.
Mr. Ferguson, it's only by chance that we're staying at the Burton's farm. We're only guests. Where is my friend?
Take some advice. Move out.
Maybe we will.
Not maybe. Move.
I want to know where my friend is first.
Slider, those two need to be given a good lesson, I think.
I told you with those two, you can't be tough enough. Fetch Tom and Bill, quick. Go.
You pretty little beggars. You're taking me for your mother, huh? Oh, go on, go away now. You're tickling me.
Daniel.
Hey, Daniel. Babe, trust me. I'll fly a salami.
I'll free you now. No worries.
Mighty lucky you come along.
Here, easy now.
That's better.
Quick, there is no time to lose.
Give me a hand there.
Come on. Let's go, huh?
Come on.
Right time to give way to your motherly instinct.
Agreed. Take that horse.
Hey, why sure? Hop, get by there. Yay!
Ferguson told me that he was partner with your husband.
Yes, for a while everything was fine, then they started quarreling.
Hey, little rising moon. Hey, if you don't give me a drop, I'll catch me death of cold. Hey, do you hear me? Come on, be nice, damn it. Come on.
And what happened afterwards?
Ferguson wanted more, always more. Land, horses, furs. My husband tried to make him go easy, but it was in vain.
You and your men go to the stable and set fire to it. The orders are to scare the women to death. The explosion will be the signal for the retreat. You shouldn't encounter any resistance. All the men are out with the cattle. And if any of them remained, we'll take care of them. Let's go.
That night, he came home upset. He told me that he had found some documents that proved that Ferguson was a thief and a murderer. Put this on.
He's a real bastard, that Ferguson.
Down! Dollar, the light. Give me the gun.
Get the cattle out.
Thank you. White Fang, the cows. Keep under cover.
Watch out, Daniel.
Get down. Beautiful tie. Nice tie for you. Hey, you want a tie, sir, huh? What do you know?
Let's hurry up. Out of here, you little mongrel. It's a signal. Let's get out of here.
Hold it. Let him refer back to that boss. He better know that we're not afraid of him. Is that so, Dollar?
Yeah.
Pennywig! Pennywig. Oh, Pennywig, why you?
Leave us alone. You too, if you don't mind, although you are his mother. Johnny and I must talk, talk as men do talk. There is no time for these things, Johnny. Now is the time to be strong. You are the man of the family now. And you must think of protecting your mother. And you can't afford to cry now. And then the farmhands will fight better if they see you strong, courageous.
Can I bury him?
No, not right now, Johnny. We'll do it when it's safe.
Can you hold my hand?
Then we'll try again. And soon. The only salvation are those documents. We must absolutely find them.
By now, someone must have taken them.
I'm sure that the documents are still there, and to find them, we'll have to go back where your husband was killed and search for them.
But we must be very careful, because I'm sure we're under continuous control.
I'm sure of it. And that's why I'll go with Johnny. We'll tell everyone that we're going hunting.
But Johnny is a child.
But quite capable. An ideal place for an ambush. A rope across the path. A dog creeps over it. And a sledge falls into the ravine. You see, no one will ever be able to say whether it was an accident or not. Well, let's get to work. Always be careful, Johnny. Keep an eye on the rope.
I found them!
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
Get my water bottle! Run, quick! Hurry!
Daniel, what must I do with the water?
You must pour it on the rope when it's breaking. And put some snow on it, too. Ferguson! Ferguson!
What do you know? These are proofs of murders committed. That's right. These documents accuse Ferguson to have allowed the death of three hunters of cold and hunger. What a bastard.
What must I do?
Nothing. Nothing. You'll do nothing. I'll take the sledge tomorrow. I better inform the Redcoats. They'll take care of him.
I tell you that I own all the required land. I only need the signature of Mrs. Burton, the widow of my late partner.
So what?
You know as well as I do how much Grizzly City needs the railway and how much the railway needs the fur hunters of Grizzly City.
Mr. Ferguson, my dear Mr. Ferguson, it has already been 2 months that the work has stopped. At 50 miles from Grizzly City. And that shows how much the management of the railway cares about this town.
And now that's enough.
Yes, enough.
That's right. We've got to tell you that, well, the line will be diverted through another place if you don't comply.
But you can't do that to me. It's more than a year that I accumulate furs for.
For?
Tell us.
For over a year, I've been convincing the hunters to bring their furs to Grizzly City. And I'm paying them double to get them to come here, you know.
Mr. Ferguson, the railway company is not concerned in your fur speculations.
It is only concerned with your having the land at the price contracted.
And this hasn't happened. Therefore, the contract is null and void.
It's only a matter of a few days. Just look over there.
Really,
I've even ordered that miniature, see?
Very nice. An exceptional job.
Oh, will it be on time? That one.
That one.
What am I saying? It's a force of habit, I guess.
In fact, there's no more time.
Yeah, we're all off schedule already, dear sir.
Please, give me a week.
No, nothing, no.
3 days.
Please, don't insist.
All right, listen here. I'll make you a last proposal. If you don't find a telegram for me by the time you get back to the company, you can then cancel the contract, okay? What do you say, Jens?
Just a moment. Come.
Can we trust him?
Well, we'll trust him so far, and he's in for a lot of money. Furthermore, coming this way is of greater advantage to us.
There's no doubt about that.
Well, I think these three days...
3 days is
enough.
3 days. But we can afford to give him more than 3 days.
Agreed, Mr. Ferguson. We can concede you 3 days.
Yes, 3 days.
If no telegram, then...
You cancel the contract.
Exactly.
Well,
of course,
business
we can't afford
business.
To be sentimental, can we now? I mean...
Let's go.
Good day to you, Mr. Ferguson.
And keep well.
And to think,
It could be so easy.
Well, it's all ready.
Thanks. See that it doesn't drink much.
I'll do my best. Daniel.
There. You don't have to worry. Everything's going to be all right.
Johnny's grown very, very fond of you. Daniel, I'm afraid. Let's leave everything. Let's go away. I'll sell the farm. Please don't go.
One must finish what one has started. And then, it's only a 3 days' journey.
Yes, but in the mountains, with the wolves, take White Fang with you.
White Fang must stay to look after you, and to look after Johnny. I won't live in peace otherwise. Okay?
Where's Johnny?
Calm down, lady.
And the wolf?
Taken care of.
Is he dead?
No, but we can kill him whenever you want to.
No. No, he's a nice dog. I'd like to keep him. And then, Johnny must be very fond of him. Well, then, you decided to talk? Very well. Hold it! It isn't nice to see a bride full of bruises. There are many other ways, you know. Take her away.
Johnny! Johnny! No! You can't do it! Coward! Murderer! Oh. Let him go. He's only a child. Leave him. Leave him alone. Let him go.
Very touching. A demonstration of motherly love, huh? Now we'll see if your motherly love will be strong enough to stop us from branding your son like a horse.
You wouldn't dare.
A nice scar on his face might even give him appeal. I'll put it back in the fire until it's real white hot. And that, my dear, is the time you have to tell me what you found in those papers. Go on, speak. My patience has a limit.
There's proof that you are a murderer.
And what else? Come on, tell me.
It states that years ago you abandoned three companions in the mountains, letting them starve to their death.
And why would I have done it?
One of them had three sacks of gold.
Almost four. He made the same mistake as I did. The day that he was drunk, he told me about the gold. The iron's almost ready.
But I told you all I knew.
You haven't given me those papers yet.
I haven't got them. Daniel's got them to take them to the Redcoats. I swear it to you, you must believe me. I'm telling the truth.
In that case, there's no problem. In the mountains, there are a lot of accidents like the one that happened to your husband, for instance. Slider, send Tom and Slim. They have the fastest team in Canada.
Johnny, Johnny.
Mush! Mush! Faster! Faster!
Bark, bark, old boy. Your master is far away. Believe me, Linda. Try and understand that I'm the first to be sorry for what has happened. All that violence. If you had listened to me immediately today, I wouldn't have hit you. And now Daniel wouldn't be in any danger.
What else do you want?
Marry you.
Marry you? You must have gone crazy.
Obviously, we'll celebrate our wedding in the Catholic faith. I'm a staunch believer. Didn't you know it?
I'll never marry you, no matter what. Clear?
Don't be so theatrical, Linda. Never. What does your never signify? Compared to Johnny's face scarred, dollar dead, and your husband's name stained? Yes, my sweet bride. Drag the name of your husband in the mud, in front of your son. And don't pretend not to understand. If I'm a murderer, your husband was my accomplice, because in all these years, he didn't denounce me.
It isn't true. It isn't true.
He preferred to blackmail me.
It isn't true, because the day he found those papers, he came home upset. And the same night, he left to go to the mountains.
Well, it may be as you say. But that is only known by you and me.
Thank you.
Our friend has left for better
Maybe
pastures.
We better go and make sure. What do you say, Tom?
No need to. Without dogs, he's a dead man. The wolves will take care of his carcass. Let's go.
Let's go.
It's the signal. Then it'll be dealt with. Let's go with that fighter.
Ferguson! Ferguson! It's done, boss. Tom signaled that Daniel's been dealt with.
Jim?
Yeah, boss.
Go to town and send a telegram to the railway company. Ferguson and wife are happy to participate to the laying of the first sleeper.
All right.
My dear, I drink to the memory of your dead hero.
Damn you, Ferguson.
Why are you all looking so sad? Tomorrow is our wedding day. Isn't that so, my dear?
Listen, since this wedding's got to go through, why didn't you buy all my ties? One of them might choke you to death. Huh?
Food is ready. Here. Nice smell, eh? Here. Come. Come. Here. You want some? There you are. You want some too? Come. Come close. Come. That a boy? Here. That's it. That's it. That's a boy. Come now. We have things to do. Come on. Let's go. Huh? It's all been done, Snyder.
Good. Did you find the priest?
Yeah, but he's a monk.
A monk?
Yeah, he's the only churchman in Lodge City. He'll be here shortly.
Welcome to the monk, then. Let's go.
As it for same, put in the lucem tuam, nefertitatem tuam. Esum lucem sedum, the factum, sum sedum, satum tuum, and tabernacus tuum, and absinotum. The comedabra vichatra, vichamus here, and Christum stabs on a man, and them tuas, come tubus in. Doris partis and fidus virisantis, as same, semper, and semper, seculorum amen. Ega absolva vos, in vilifant inferus, auditorium nostrum, in amenitusum, in deram, and hispanic, profundis, santros, gedan de Catilina, sepotemnum nostrum domum, and misericordiae in temperance, dominationem, and scultarum santus, and timen, and amnistus santus. Abiter, in gloria patria, and in gentium festivum deus, et misim gandum vespigis, ut totem corpum vostrum vita paternam, amen. And in auditorium nostrum, Deus conversus, infere nos, in vers tuas, in perditum nintem. With you, Thomas Ferguson, take for your legitimate spouse, dear present, Linda Britt.
I do.
And with you, Linda, take for your spouse, dear present, Thomas Ferguson.
Yes.
Ega coningo vos, in matrimonium, nomine Patris, et Filii, Spiritus Sanctus, amen. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus. And now, my children, you may go in peace.
Gentlemen, the bar is at your disposal. Wish me luck and have a good time. You must smile, my dear. Oh, Father, this is for the celebration.
No, 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 thank you. I cannot take money. I'm not allowed. By the way, I have a surprise for you. Here. You remember him?
White Fang!
End of the line for you, Ferguson.
Daniel!
The Mounties are on the way to get you.
Daniel!
Slider!
Good.
No.
Oh, man, sir. Stop. You will buy a pie.
As many as you want. As many as you want. I love pies.
You're a good boy. You can join the others for now. Say, stop. Would you like a pie?
No, I don't want any.
No.
Oh, yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Mr. Ferguson, they're coming for the boy. Stay still. If you move, I'll clobber you.
Take this.
I'll show you. You better be quiet now. We better get out of here, boss. Damn dog.
No!
Thanks to your bravery.
To your heroism and social conscience.
We are happy to inaugurate the first journey from Grizzly to Large City.
Station Master.
Yeah.
$5.